Goran, tell us how you came about making this story and how you got it up on the screen.
You know, I read a short story that I liked a lot. The film is based on a short story by Israeli author. His name is Edgar Carret. And I liked the story a lot. And I met Edgar in Los Angeles when there was a book reading, because the, you know, when the book was published in the USA. And I asked him for the rights, and he wanted to see the script, and he liked it, and he gave me the rights. That's how it all started.
Did Goran send you the script, or?
No, I didn't know Goran prior to this. I was doing something else, and I came in. I came in and I met him. I read the script, and I had never read anything like it. You know, the world that he created on paper. And then I came in and I met him, and he asked me to do. I actually wanted to be Zia when I first came in, and I connected with Zia. And then I came in and I had a big pompadour haircut and some chops and stuff, and I was a torn mustache and some things. And he said, "Would you read for, you know, Eugene?" And the Russian actually threw me, and I said, "Can you give me a couple of days to come back?" And so and I did, and you know, it just was kind of serendipitous.
So what's the point of living when life is so unfair and everything? Just telling you this because you're the smartest person I know. And if you don't give me one good reason to keep living and tell me what's the meaning of life, I'm gonna do this.
Step down from the table.
No. First tell me.
Step down from the table and I'll tell you.
Always somewhere along the line you feel like it's going to fall completely apart, and this one, it was pretty brutal. And some of this, the scenes with the Messiah, with the castle, I mean, those were some long, hard days, but I mean, again, he held it together. He held it together. And so, you know, when we watch it sometimes, we get a bit giddy that it's up there, you know, because it's, you got some stories, underneath stories, you know.
For the actors, was it difficult in the afterworld to not smile?
Yeah.
What were some of the scenes that you guys cut from the movie? And are those going to be on the DVD? We talked about this a little bit before, the ice cream thing. If you want to share a couple things that got the axe. Who we might see you later.
The dog, so we said. There was one of the scenes with the Arab taxi driver, but they're not going to be really suicide bomber, and he drove you to the hotel somewhere, and this hotel was closed, so they ended up sleeping in the car, the whole bars cut out. And then there was a scene with Eugene having the romance with the stop by one of their stops was at the ice cream store. You tell more about that.
I got cut out quite a bit now that we're talking about this part. we had an amazing scene between myself and the Arab taxi driver. I'm saying, look at this guy. That part, it's briefly in the piece. We get in the back of the taxi cab, and I had this dialogue with this Arab taxi driver about, so I guess it didn't work out, huh, brother? And he's like, what do you mean? I'm like, well, don't you promise 1,000 virgins? And like, you know, and it's heated, and we start drinking together, and it's an amazing scene. It didn't forward the piece, which, it's tough. But, and then we stop by, we buy. At one point, I need a beer, I need a drink bad in the piece, and we don't have any, there's no liquor stores, so I get this idea to drive by this ice cream shop and get some cherry liquor ice cream, and I ask this sexy 65-year-old who's behind the counter, her and I, and I'm asking her, so how much of this do we need to get drunk here? And she says, you need about 10 gallons, and I'm like, let's pack it up and go. And I cruise back to the back, and her and I have this wild, this pretty wild scene that got mixed. Those two got, you know, for sure got cut. I write a few songs.
Why did they have to?
Just didn't forward the story, man. Do you know what I mean? It's one of those painful things, man. It's hard. I mean, there's a couple of people that are really great in this piece. There's a couple of other scenes. There's another scene with two really good actresses between Z and I and them two. We meet these two actresses, and one of them is great, just great, just wonderful, open. And we heard I had this romantic thing. You know, Eugene was almost falling in love several times in the piece until he finds the nook. And we had this great scene, and it just got completely cut out. I mean, you have to tell her that it's, you know, it's brutal. You know, it's brutal because you love them. I mean, we worked through the night till the sun came up, you know that?
Yeah.
It just didn't work, brother, for the scene. And so it's got to go.
Well, guys, thanks a lot.
Thank you.